I want to assure you, men, that after the bombardment you have seen, you'll be able to go over the top with a walking stick. And when you get to Montauban, you'll find that the Germans are all dead. Not even a rat would have survived. Shall I continue?
Oh, please, sir.
Now, we will have control of Montauban village by 11 a.m. The field kitchens will be following. We'll be able to provide you all with a hot meal. I want to assure you, men, that success is guaranteed. Casualties are expected to be no more than 10%. And in fact, when you set off over the top, you'll be able to slope arms, light your pipes, your cigarettes, and march all the way to Bapaume before you meet a single live German.
Thumbs up, hats off, big cheer!
Thank you, Colonel. That was wonderful. We'll have you in the flickers yet, sir.
Over my dead body. Yes. Now, you fellows finish with me.
One more thing, sir. Inspection the casualty clearing station.
Fine. Shall we go? Thank you, men. Good luck.
We'll give them hell, sir.
Yes!
Yes, well done. Oh, and look here. I want you lads to win as many medals for the battalion as possible.
That's right, Hugh. You won't be there.
No, I won't be. But you lot will.
Stand up!
Thank you, Sergeant.
Sir.
Stand to. Come on now, stand to. Stand to. Wakey, wakey, come on there. Come on, wake up. Stand to. Stand to, you daddy, belly basket.
Why are we doing this, McFarlane? Explain. Why? Why?
Stand to, innit? Just in case they attack.
Yeah, but we're going to attack them. Tomorrow. Or the day after. They know that. Why would they attack us when...
Oi, you lot! Shut it down there!
Some of these men are improperly dressed, Sergeant.
Yes, sir. What's he waiting for?
Pillock.
The all clear. Once we've got that, it's Bracky.
Go on, have a look, McFarlane. Tell us what you see.
Don't be daft.
Stand down!
Go on, have a look, McFarlane. Don't you want to know what the German lines look like?
Go on, Eddie.
Just a quick look, Ed, yeah? I tell you what, I'll give you two bob.
Well, you look if you want to.
I would, but it's right in front of you, mate.
Two bob, man. No tick.
Two bob's yours, Ed. It's yours. Tell us what it looks like.
Nothing much. It's like a grassy hill. See a bit of earth at top. A bit of their wire.
Is that all?
It's like a hill going up to the lip of a quarry. Far off, like. A quarter of a mile. Grass is blowing. Sort of calm. Like a sloping meadow. Sloping up. It's gentle.
That ain't worth two bob, sunshine.
Yes!
Get the banner! Get the banner! Get the banner!
The theme that I'm going to talk about today is simply putting information before you that you wouldn't normally get through mainstream channels. It's not something that I'm trying to sell to you. It's not something I'm trying to get you to believe, because the world is drowning in freaking people standing up and telling others what they should think. Whether it's religion, whether it's politics, whether it's science, whatever it is, medicine, we're constantly being told, this is how it is, you must believe it, and if you don't believe it, you're wrong. So all I'm doing tonight is putting information before you, and what you make of it not only doesn't matter to me, it's none of my sodding business what you make of what I say. It's your business. And so I just want to emphasize from the start that I'm not here to get you to believe anything. Just to say there is another way of looking at this thing called life and world events. As we hurtle by the day, much more than ever appears in the mainstream media, towards Orwell's society. Gandhi said, an error does not become truth by reason of multiplied propagation, nor does truth become error because no one will see it. He also said, even if you are in a minority of one, the truth is still the truth. The truth is not something you believe. The truth is something that is. And it's your relationship to it that is the decision we make. Obviously, there are different versions of truth and there's different ways of looking at life. But truth itself is not something we believe. It is something that we align with or don't align with. So, in short, if one person is standing up and saying something, it doesn't mean it's not true. Just because everybody seems to be saying the same thing doesn't mean it is true. There was a time when, if I'd have stood here centuries ago and said the earth was round, guys, a nutter. Talking about. And it's interesting that if you want to suppress someone's sense of what's possible, all you need to do overwhelmingly is to suppress the information they receive about what is possible, and then boom, box. So the earth's not flat, it's a sphere. Level of information. You're mad. What about the people on the bottom? They fall off. Introduce more information. Law of gravity. Ah, the apparently ridiculous now becomes possible. The difference between the two, the level of information. So he who controls information controls our sense of possibility. Hence what he was talking about. The world seems so utterly confusing. It seems so complex, so bewildering. What's this? What's that? How's that? What's going on? And the reason it seems so bewildering and so complex is because we lack the level of information in the mainstream, where most people get their information from, to understand what's going on and how the parts fit together. Things can look in isolation interesting. Oh yeah, what's going on here? Wonder what that's about. And why is he doing that? And what's this event here? Why has this happened? But when you go boom, 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 and connect the dots, suddenly, oh, so that's what's going on. Connecting the dots is absolutely crucial. And I started 20 years ago on a quest to understand two things. The nature of life. Who are we? What are we doing here? And who really controls world events and what we call society, and to what end? And of course, we all start out with this complexity and this bewilderment. But when you start connecting the dots, what's going on becomes the proverbial elephant in the sodden living room. World events, overwhelmingly, the major ones that change society, move us in a certain direction, are not by accident but by design. I often hear people say, do you believe in the conspiracy theory of history or the cock-up theory? As if, like, you've got to choose. Some things that happen in the world are cock-ups, mistakes people have made. Oh, didn't mean that. But within that are coldly calculated changes in society, which are now becoming daily so obvious, to take the power over the global state, because that's what they want, and that's what they're flying towards by the day, in the hands of a ludicrously few people. We live in a world of conflict and war and famine, where people are a few people control and hijack the wealth at the expense of the vast majority. We live in a world which, take a step back, deep breath, look at it again, is utterly bloody insane. When we open our minds, or go beyond that even, then we start to see reality in a different way. This is a wonderful quote. You were born an original, don't die a copy. So many people do that. They go through their lives thinking the norm in society is the only possible perception of reality. The key to everything else in this global conspiracy is to put humanity into a false identity, a false belief in who we are. It has to get us to see ourselves in terms of little me, powerlessness. What can I do? I'm just Joe Public. And I'm just Ethel Jones or Charlie Smith. That's who I am. I'm the reflection in the mirror. That's me. I have no power. When in fact, we are infinite consciousness having an experience as Charlie Smith or Ethel Jones. But what the manipulation has to do to put us in the box of mass control is to persuade us that we are the experience. And they've done it brilliantly so far.